Let's talk about the basics of insulin index. I think this is quite interesting because all people are just very worried about that the insulin spikes and that insulin becomes ineffective if you eat plant-based foods that are high in carbs. So let's look at the actual numbers. And just for the record, you can see that the insulin index here is not the same as the glycemic index or the glycemic load. Because they look at the blood glucose, so how much sugar we have in the blood, but the insulin index looks as how much insulin you have in the blood. And the insulin index is looking into the caloric, the energy in the food, like 250 kilocalories. And the GI and GL is looking into the carbohydrate content of the food, like 50 grams here. So let's dive into the numbers here. Here you can see that you have the food type, the glucose score, and the insulin score, and the satiety score, which means that if this is high, you didn't need to eat more. So the first one is an all brand breakfast cereal, and its glucose score is low, and the insulin score is even lower, and we have a satiety score of 151. So compared to like porridge, you're not as satiated as if you ate. You're not satiated after eating all brand compared to porridge, because the porridge has 209, and but the insulin score is a bit higher. I don't think that doesn't even matter, but the glucose score is also a bit higher. I think that the all brand has more protein in it. But anyway, let's look at some interesting stuff here. And even things as yogurt, even though the sugar content isn't very high, the insulin spike is crazy. And just for the record, all these foods are compared to the white bread. The white bread is the base of here on 100. So if you sort here on the insulin score, you can see that if you eat white pasta or brown pasta, your insulin score is lower than eating beef or any other animal product, many other animal products. So you don't need to focus on the insulin score. The most important thing is to remove the fat from your diet, eat whole foods, and then you don't need to worry about the glycemic index or glycemic load or the insulin index or whatever. It's the body will handle all the sugars in your blood and pull it out again very fast because it's the way the body works. It needs the sugar in the muscles, and if it's possible for the insulin to move the sugar from the bloodstream into the muscles or into the brain without the inefficiency of going through a lot of fat or wall of fat, then it all works as it's supposed to. But if you fill your body with fat and fill your bloodstream with fat, then you will get diabetes at some point. So it's not the sugar in most cases, it's the fat. So why don't you hear that all these banana eating people are getting diabetes? It's the fat people that are getting the diabetes. So it must be the sugar, right? From whole foods, plant-based, right? Yeah, go figure.